So we start with the case one. Here is 23-year-old male patient who has undergone appendectomy. Day 5 post-operative, he develops redness, pain, exudate at the surgical site. Okay. So can you guess what it is? These are signs of inflammation. Redness, pain and exudate. And there are also signs of infection. The second case is, it's a post-chemotherapy patient, 69-year-old female. She has IV catheter in situ for almost 15 days. And she complains of high-grade continuous type of fever. So what do you feel? What is this? Right, this is bloodstream infection. When you have high-grade fever and when there is in situ IV catheter for a long time, it definitely indicates bloodstream infections. Okay. Then the third case, after attending a dinner at a social gathering, 18 patients came to the casualty of the hospital at 2 a.m. There was severe abdominal pain and watery diarrhea. The complaint was same for all the patients. So what is this likely to be? Right, correct. So all of them are eating at the same place. The source is same. And they are having GI infections. So this is food poisoning. Okay. Now there are these few cases. Furuncle, multiple pus discharging points with inflammation, redness. This is called as carbuncle. Then this is a site where you see inflammation, redness, it's widespread. This is cellulitis. And this is the axillary region where it shows small dots which are red in color, hyperemic. This is the case of hidradenitis suppurativa. Okay. A small baby in NICU has skin exfoliation to the extent that all the skin all over his body is exfoliated. This is the wide spectrum of a common pathogen for all these different histories, that is surgical site infection, then bloodstream infection due to IV, then food poisoning, then this baby, then different cutaneous infections. The causative agent is one and the same, that is Staphylococcus. And in Staphylococcus, the most common species is Staphylococcus aureus. So you'll get different short notes out of that. Coagulase test has been asked maximum times. Apart from that, there would be questions like mention pathogenic test done for identification of Staph aureus with a note on coagulase test. Then in summer 2016, name 4 diseases produced by Staph aureus and describe in brief staphylococcal food poisoning. Then recently in winter 2016, there was a question, lab diagnosis of staphylococcal wound infection. Then in long questions, explain the basis of multisystem involvement and florid manifestation of staphylococcal food poisoning and toxic shock syndrome. This was asked in winter 2004. And enumerate organism causing food poisoning. This is a separate question for 2 marks. And describe morphology, cultural characters, pathogenicity, lab diagnosis of infection caused by Staph aureus. So this is another question for 4 marks. So you can have staphylococcus everywhere. They will give you gram staining slides of Staph aureus. You'll have Staph aureus which is inoculated on nutrient agar with different pigments. You'll have Staph aureus inoculated on blood agar with beta hemolysis, so on and so forth. So you just cannot pass second year exam without doing Staph. Okay.